What's scary about dating is the older men are, the more sexual issues they have. They can't get a in bed waiting for them.
Your PowerPoint presentation.
It will be on my site later. It will be available.
buzzwords, what language you're using. So, for example, if I were to have a doc type, I would be a doc type English because I'm speaking to you in English. Some of you might have doc type Spanish because you speak Spanish. This tells that would be for you, like, as a human. This is for your website. You have a doc type HTML because you're using HTML. So your browser knows that, okay, I'm going to read this as HTML. And then you have the HTML tags. That says that everything in here, all of that is HTML. Everything between those tags, all of the content, is HTML. So you see that we have that opening tag, we have that end tag, everything in between is HTML. Then we have the head and the body. The head is like the brain of the website. It tells what's going on, but you don't actually see it. Kind of like me, you don't see my brain, but you know I have news. Obviously, I have some sort of brain. And then the body is what you see when you look at a website. So in the head, you have tags like the title, like the meta, like the link, as the style sheet, like photos, script head. Any of you who are familiar with SEO are familiar with title and meta tags. A lot of you probably talk about that. I'm not going to go into that. But that, as you can see, you don't actually see any of that. You can just think, this is what's going on, this is the information you need to know. Then you look at the body tag. Most websites will have something like a header, like a center, a content, or a sidebar, like a footer. As you can see, this is kind of dividing up your website, laying it out, and showing, okay, this is how it's supposed to look. These are how things are separated. So what happens when I apply the HTML to my site? This is my site with just HTML, which is a lot better than this, but still not this. So we still have a lot of work to do. So next we need CSS, because that is the majority of what is making the site look good. And that's what we're talking about. So this is a CSS style sheet. For CSS, you usually put it in a separate style, not in the same document as your HTML. It can be done, but it's usually better just to have one big separate style sheet with all of your styles. It keeps them together, keeps them organized, it's good. So again, you probably have no idea what's going on with that, so I'm going to explain it. CSS, you have a selector, which is a way of saying, okay, so this is the thing in your HTML document that I want to apply these styles to. And you have attributes, which is saying, okay, this is a style I'm applying, and the value of that style. So for example, a selector, the element in your HTML, can be your selectors. So we just spoke about this, about elements. For example, the A element, like I was just saying, that's an HTML element. And you can use that to, right here we're saying, every single A element in my website, I want its color to be red. And so now every single A element on your site will be red, instead of the normal blue underline that you will see. So that is using an element selector to find that. Then you have the ID selector. ID is an HTML attribute. You can do, for example, here I would say ID equals center on any HTML tag. You can add that attribute pretty much wherever you want. So this is saying for the tag that has the ID of center, I want the background to be that color. Now that doesn't look like a color, does it? That looks like a big jumbled, who knows what. That, it's not a text button, it's a way of referring to colors, because you only have names for so many colors. You want to be able to use any color out there on your site. So, the pound sign and the six numbers or digits, numbers or letters, that is a way to refer a different color. So that's how you use the ID. You can also use a class attribute. It's used pretty much the same way as ID. It's just another attribute on your HTML tag. So this one, for example, you can do class equals post in our HTML tag, and then refer to it with the period post. The difference between IDs and classes, you can only use an ID once in your entire web page. So I cannot have five different HTML tags with ID center. You just can't do it. I mean, you could, but you break things, so I wouldn't recommend it. ID once, that's it. For a class, you can use a class as many times as you want. So for example, on my blog page, say I have 10 different posts displaying. They can all have class equals post, because I want to have the same styles for all of them. So it makes sense to use the class for every single one of them. And there you have it. So, excuse me. There are a lot of common CSS attributes. Color, that's pretty obvious. It defines the color of something. You can do it with the word, like I said, red, green, blue. Or more commonly, you can use the hex. I just showed you the six numbers or letters to refer to color. And you can do width or height or something. And if you have an image, you want to say, okay, I don't want it to fill my whole page. I only want it, 500 pixels wide. You can set that with the width and the height. Then you have a background. For us, we do our header as a background. Yes. Square bullet points, or you can change that. Line height, Kuroko tag and a Bond Sequoia tag. Everything between those two tags is PHP code. So PHP code can look something like that. You have a function that you're calling, and then you have can have parameters that you pass into the function. Remember the semicolon. Semicolon is important. So how is this important? How do you do PHP when you work on things? This is an example of the infamous loop that pretty much every WordPress site out there now uses. You can see that a PHP is mixed in with my HTML. So all the stuff in white, that's all PHP. All the stuff in red is the HTML. So we can mix it up like that. As long as you have the opening and closing PHP tags, your browser's going to know, okay, that's PHP. Think of it as PHP. I should render it as PHP. Do you remember that you have to have it as a PHP file to use PHP? So, you know, have index.php, header.php. PHP files are important, mostly your WordPress files, objects and files. So that is pretty much how PHP works. So now when you're looking at WordPress, when you're looking at PHP, you know that that is PHP. Thank you.
What I discovered online is called Headway. It's a theme builder, and it's very user-friendly. It doesn't require much of I can't, as a beginner myself, I can't. That's the perfect one. It may help give you some ideas.
Awesome, thank you.
Yeah, if they're
going to
be
there are a lot of scenes offer, you know, SEO, optimize,
okay to write now, but I have a better patch. I think there's something to talk about later.
On your blog for smartphones?
No. Not really.
You think that's a good idea?
As a smartphone user, I know, because it really annoys me when I can't stuff as easily on the smartphone version. But it's probably going to depend on you and on the users. Pretty dependent on something.
I just wanted to add something with that guy said about Headway. The site's actually headwaythemes.com. It was pretty interesting.
Is anyone here using the Studio Quest Genesis?
Yeah.
I'm just getting started. You do end up having to go right. The first thing you have to do is start changing the CSS. Well, isn't that common to me? I don't know. I think you would teach you your CSS.
Some of them will have a
less coding, yeah. Each page you can create.